Everybody say yes, yes, to VBS.
Gentlemen, it's VBS season, and our first stop has got to be Dudley Baptist Church. We're here tonight, and we've got children pastor here with us, Mr. Paul Lay. Mr. Paul, what is it? It's day three?
This is day three of our VBS. We started on Sunday,
okay,
and we go through Thursday.
So gotcha.
It'll be our last night.
I got you. So how's it been so far?
Oh, it's been great. You know, Sunday we started off, had a great crowd. Each night has grown, so looking forward to what the last night's going to bring. So
yeah, no doubt. So let's talk about preparations for this thing. How much goes into getting ready for a thing like this?
Wow, that's a loaded question right there. There's a lot of stuff that goes into doing a VBS. As you see, our backdrops, the decorations, we started decorating early last week.
Okay.
And then we have our opening session that's written by a couple of our children's ministry team leaders, Lee Allen and Lucy West, do that. And so they lead us into that. So then they also do our closing aspects. So there's a lot that goes into the planning of VBS and what it's about, even from the decorating to the snacks, to the games, to the Bible stories, to the crafts that even go on, because you got to order a lot of stuff. And especially when you are doing VBS with preschoolers, it takes a lot, you know, with that going on. But it's exciting. We're looking forward to seeing what God's going to do this week.
Yeah, no doubt. And you talk about all the people who just have to come together. How many volunteers do we have here?
Wow, Jackson, that's an interesting question, too. We probably have
a good bit,
good bit 65, 70 people that help out. And so, you know, you can never have enough. But, man, God has blessed us this week with a lot of wonderful youth and young adults and also adults to help us out in many ways. So,
yeah, how important is that for you? And how much weight does that take off you to have, you know, the church is going to come step up and help you out at this?
Oh, man, when the church steps up, it takes a lot of weight off, especially the children's pastor's shoulders, because you can't do it on your own. And it's a community, and we do this, and, you know, we all come together, and we work for the glory of God. And it's about serving Christ this week and serving these children who are coming each and every night. So if it wasn't for everybody who comes out, VBS wouldn't happen.
That's right.
So this year, the theme, Stellar. Tell me about the theme this year. Stellar, what's it all about? What are we trying to teach?
Stellar is a VBS product of group publishing, and our theme is Stellar, Shine Jesus' Light.
Okay.
So what we're teaching the kids each night to shine Jesus' light, and we do that through Bible memory buddies. We do that through the stories. We do that through the crafts, that they always know that they need to shine their light for Christ.
There you go. Awesome. So you've got 9 crews, am I right about that?
Yes, nine crews.
Nine crews. So walk our viewers through, what would a crew do on a given night here at VBS?
Okay, we actually would have 10 crews, I guess, if you count our preschoolers.
Okay.
We have 18 preschoolers this week.
Gotcha.
That's wonderful. They go through the same format that our school-age kids go through, which is they go to 4 different stations. They go to missions and snacks, where they learn about a missions each night, and they have the snacks there. We have imagination station, which is our crafts.
Gotcha.
We have Bible adventures, which is our a course where they learn the Bible story, and who was taught by Miss Vicki Acord and Miss Elaine Brantley, who do a wonderful job of presenting God's gospel and to the kids. So, and lastly, what they like the most is the Galactic Games, the All-Star Games that we have. So it's a wonderful time of these different 4 stations, and the crew leader's responsibility is to take them to each station throughout the night.
For sure. And Mr. Paul, like, you know, the most important thing we're doing, like, we're trying to, like you say, we're teaching that gospel. And how are you able to do that? Because VBS is tough, man. You got all these kids. I mean, we even got the preschool kids, and you got to get snacks and food and everything else. But how, at the end of the day, are we able to present the gospel here?
Well, the cool thing is, Jackson, at each station, they review what they learned in the Bible story, okay, which is the story itself. Last night was at Kias. Tonight they're going to learn about Jesus riding into Jerusalem, getting ready for the crucifixion, which they'll go through tomorrow night. And so they review that at each station they go to, like missions and snacks. She'll review the Bible point. She'll review the Bible story. When they go to games, they do the same thing. So the gospel is being presented to the kids at each station, which is pretty great because they're really getting it. Right. And they get it here in opening, and they'll get it again in closing. Right. So actually, they're getting it six times during the night. So then tomorrow night, we're going to do a gospel presentation and give the kids an opportunity to ask Jesus into their heart. So we're looking forward to what God's going to do then.
Yeah, for sure. It's going to be a great time of response. It's been a great week so far.
Yes.
About halfway there. A lot more still to come here. Stellar VBS here at Dudley Baptist Church. It's the children's pastor, Mr. Paul. Ladies and gentlemen, I mean, the two ladies that keep it going year in and year out here at Dudley Baptist for VBS. We've got Miss Lee here with us and Miss Lucy. How y'all doing tonight?
Doing well.
There we go. So look, y'all are hard at work for VBS. Tell me what y'all do. Tell our viewers what y'all do here at VBS.
Well, we do the worship rally, the opening and the closing. Okay. So when all the children come in, we get them hyped up, ready for vacation Bible school, sing some songs, have a few skits, just have a lot of fun with them.
There you go. And Miss Lucy, I mean, you got this get up on. What's going on here?
I'm training to be a captain. Now, I'm a future former mechanic, but I'm going to be a captain.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, and what's with the Twinkies? You had a lot of Twinkies here on stage. What's going on with
that? Well, see, in order to survive on the moon for a whole week, I needed 15 cases of Twinkies. That's like 3 cases a day, and I might be able to survive for the whole week.
That's it? You may need maybe a few more.
I might need a few more. I did offer some to her and try to throw some up to Jesus, but, you know, they just came right back down, so I can still eat them.
Yeah, those are for you right there.
Yeah.
So, I mean, look, taking it back, when I was a little tyke, it was Miss Lucy and Miss Lee here doing it at VBS. I mean, that's how I remember it. How long have y'all been doing it?
I have no idea.
He's trying to make us look old.
I mean,
already look short. Do I have to look old too?
No. What I'm saying, y'all just got it down. Y'all still rolling. I mean, it's impressive. That's what I'm saying.
It's been a long time. I really don't know how long.
I don't have any idea how many years.
As long as I can remember, I came in probably at 4 years old, something like that. Mm-hmm. And I'm, you know, that's about 15 years. Quick math, something like that. So it's been going on a while. Tell me about that. I mean, take it back. When did y'all two kind of, well, you don't know the date, but I guess, you know, what got y'all two doing it together?
We're sisters.
Yup, word.
That helps.
So, just kind of like we naturally vibe together. Yeah. You know, we can, the ones where we get to argue, those are the best skits because they're just so natural.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I can see it.
Well, see, I started doing the song, the worship. Right. That was my job. I was in the old choir room, and I did worship. And then one year they decided to do this worship rally with live acting instead of the video, and that's where she came in, and her wonderful mind developed these great scripts, and somehow I was written into it.
Yep, there you go.
And so I was moved from the worship songs to the worship rally.
There you go. Okay, and we are rocking the worship rally, you know what I'm saying. So, talking about those scripts, do you write those straight up, or are you getting those and then kind of tweaking them? How does that go?
When we first started doing it, wrote them straight up.
Okay.
But now they include a lot of script with it, so I can just kind of tweak it, make it work for us, kind of combine it so that we get all the elements in there that we want.
There you go.
But a lot of the character skit part is already done, which makes my job much easier.
There you go. And then look, y'all.
She's always serious. I'm always silly. I don't know. I don't understand.
But it works. Y'all knock it out every night, every year. I can tell you. I've seen most of them, so for sure. So look, y'all been doing it so long. Like we said, what's so special about BBS that keeps y'all coming back year in and year out?
The kids.
Yeah.
Just getting the opportunity. I mean, how often do you have that you get to spend a whole week or at least every night, you know, with a bunch of kids and just really being able to enjoy learning about Jesus?
That's it.
And that's the thing, is getting to pour into them and them just enjoy it.
Right.
Learning that being a Christian is fun.
Right.
That it's not just rules that you can't do and can't do, but just having a good time.
No doubt. Yeah, it's awesome. So glad what y'all do here. And look, I look forward to seeing y'all back for years to come. Is that safe to say? I mean, I don't know. What do you think?
I don't know. We'll just have to see what next year brings.
I guess so. I guess we'll just have to come on back next year.
You had to come back.
We'll see. Look, thank y'all so much for what you do. Loving on these kids. Teach them about Jesus, what it's all about. Miss Lucy, Miss Lee, thank y'all.
Thank you.
I'm Heath Richter, and we just want to invite everybody to come on down to the Houston Clinic and check us out at our new facility. We've been in Dublin for a while now, obviously, but have a new office here, and we'd just like you to come down and see some of the new stuff we're offering. And if you need to get checked out, we'd be glad to do that for you. We've got able to do some ultrasound-guided injections now and physical therapy and just a little bit better space, so hopefully we can get you in and out of here a little bit quicker.
Come by and see us today at our brand new location, the Houston Clinic, Medical Drive in Dublin.
Hi, I'm Meg Greer Evans with Middle Georgia Estate Planning here in Dublin, Georgia. At Middle Georgia Estate Planning, we focus on estate planning, which covers the creation of wills, powers of attorney, and health care directives, as well as the creation of revocable or irrevocable trusts. We also specialize in elder law and can assist with guardianships and conservatorships, as well as asset protection for those that are looking to their elder years in life and wondering how they'll plan for their care. If you have any questions about estate planning or elder law, or how you can protect your assets for your care and the future of your family, give us a call at 478-272-2885.
Ladies and gentlemen, still at the stellar VBS here at Dudley Baptist Church, we've got Miss Callie Ray Carter here with us, Miss Haley with us. And let's start out. Look, y'all are the two interns here at Dudley Baptist Church.
Yes.
How is that going?
It's been really good. So we started a couple weeks ago and we're here at the church. I'm the children's intern, okay. So I get to hang out with the kiddos for VBS this week.
Okay. And I'm the youth intern, so I'll be helping with the youth ministry under Mr. Clint this summer.
There you go. So how did that come about? How did y'all two end up interning here at Dudley?
So they had the application open, and we both got to apply, and then we ended up getting selected, and now we get to just hang out with the youth pastors and or the youth pastor and the children's pastor and get to hang out with the kiddos. So it's fun.
Yeah, sounds pretty fun. So y'all are here day in and day out, is that what you're telling me?
For the most part. Okay. Sometimes there's ministry that doesn't always take place in the office. Like we have a few camps and some other fun activities planned throughout the summer. Okay. So yeah, we're just helping out the pastors.
There you go. So interning. So y'all are pushing the kids camp and youth camp, right?
Yes,
okay. That should be fun.
I'll be at Send Your Kid for sure.
Okay. Yeah, no doubt. Who wouldn't? So tell me, what are your responsibilities here as the interns?
So for me, it looks a little different than Callie because I'm under the children's.
Right.
So this week specifically has been all about VBS, Vacation Bible School. So we've been here making sure all the stations run smoothly, all the papers, all the kiddos get checked in, all of that nature. And so it's been really fun. Our kiddos are actually coming in right now for our next station.
Yeah, so we'll wrap this interview up quick. But Callie, kind of tell me about what are your responsibilities here?
For the most part, just planning events for the youth that we think they would enjoy. Like we're going kayaking next week. And then we have the big Syracuse mission trip coming up in a few weeks. So we're just preparing for that, sending out emails, making sure everyone knows what's going on and everything. So,
I think we're all three going on that. So y'all stay tuned for that. Maybe a little wrap up. So Haley, I just saw you in there talking. You had a bunch of kids. What was going on there?
So at my station, we're teaching them about missions, and then they also get a little snack while they're in there. So we're teaching them, just making them more aware of what they're learning here can apply to the big world, because it's easy just for them to sit here and learn a bunch of things, but then not go out and know how to apply it. And so we're showing them some videos, running through a couple of real life application things that they can take out into the real world with them.
There you go. Awesome. And look, not too long ago, we were at VBS. I know me and Callie were here at DBC, and Haley, I'm sure you were VBS in somewhere.
Yes.
Talk about that. I mean, because I remember how great VBS was. Well, I mean, talk about your experiences at VBS and now here giving back.
It's actually really cool because I just remember going through all the themes and doing all the dances and going through all the stations. So now it's I get to pour out a little bit of what I learned in VBS, growing up and everything, and get to serve these little kids and make sure they're having the best experience possible.
That's it. And that is what we are here trying to do, teaching these youngins about Jesus. Let's have a good time as well at VBS. Thank y'all, Haley and Callie. All right, hey, we're making a stop here at Rec, and we've got Mr. Chase Horn with us, Mr. Levi Daly with us. What's going on out here at Rec, boys?
We just played some high five kickball.
Okay, high five kickball.
They roll it to you and you high kick it, kickball. And you have to give everybody a high five before you get tagged with the ball.
Okay, that sounds like some good teamwork. And Lucas, we've got Lucas here with us. He's stopping in. Chase, tell me what got you out here working at VBS.
I'll tell you what, I've loved VBS since I was a kid, and I thought it was a great opportunity to give back. I was in town for the weekend. I said, sure, I'll give it a whirl.
Yeah, for sure. So, you know, you're off at college, but you come back here. How important is it, you know, you're still giving back here at Dudley?
You know, this is perfect. This is a place that raised me. You know, a lot of people rubbed off on me when I was a young kid, put me on a great direction, even though I wasn't, you know, the best kid here. But, you know, I think it's important for me to come here and try to give back.
Yeah, granted. And you were a great Joseph back in the day as well.
Yeah.
So, Levi, so tell me, you're leading a crew, is that right? Mm-hmm. Or you're one
I'm
of
helping
the crew leaders.
With
yeah, so tell me how that's going.
It's going pretty good. I helped last year doing the same thing. Yeah. So it's a lot, you know, they're a lot to handle, but it's worth it.
Yeah, what age you got?
Like of kids?
Yeah.
The preschoolers.
Okay, that's pretty tough, but yeah. I mean, I think you're the man for the job, no doubt about that. So y'all have been here all three nights. Tell me about that. Yeah?
Yeah, right? We've been here. Well, I got back Monday, so I've been here for the past two.
I've been here every day, and I'll be here today and tomorrow, but I'm not going to be here Thursday.
What's up with that, man?
I got a soccer game.
Okay, I guess. But listen, you know, how has it going for y'all? Because you were here last night, you've been here the first two nights. How's it been?
It's been pretty good. You know, the first night was kind of chaotic with everybody signing in and finding where they needed to be, but it's been better.
No doubt. How'd last night turn out for you?
It went good. You know, these kids, they come out here for rec. They've been cooped up. These are the little kids. They're ready to get it out of their system. They're wild group, and you know, it's good. It's good.
For sure. And you're out here at rec. You know, it's not just you. You got Coach Brian Brown with you as well. Uh-huh. Our viewers may know Coach Brown. We mentioned him, you know, on my Dublin Fighting Irish baseball show. How's it been working with Coach Brown out here?
You know, he's a great person to, you know, look up to, I think. He does a fantastic job. He leads the way, and I just follow along.
That's a guy you want to follow. Ladies and gentlemen, we're out here at rec. We've got Levi Dudley here with us and Chase. Thank y'all.
Yep, God bless.
North, south, east, or west, Friendly Gus is on your way today. Fuel up with Friendly Gus's delicious breakfast, made fresh every day. Your wallet and your belly will thank you. Choose from our 20, 40, and 60-piece chicken finger and wing platters. And don't forget the tater logs. Our food is always fresh and our service is always friendly. Friendly Gus, on your way today. Also, shop Cochran Brothers Cash and Carry at 320 South Jefferson in Dublin for additional items like paper products, chicken wings, bulk drinks, spices, sauces, and more.
Father's Day is just around the corner. Better hurry to Roach Farm and Garden. It's Father's Day and I know what Dad wants. A Bayou Classic, griddle, new grill, or smoker, in that order. Tired of seeing Dad in holy clothes and boots? Roach Farm and Garden has a great Carhartt and Georgia boot selection. It's Father's Day and a new knife or flashlight never disappoints. Get to Roach Farm and Garden today. Does your dad hunt? Pick up some deer feed, corn, or salt blocks, or even trophy rock. There's something for everyone at Roach Farm and Garden. Two locations, Dublin and Wrightsville.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got to do it quick, but we got Miss Elaine here with us in between groups. Miss Elaine, tell me about your station in here.
This is Bible study.
Okay.
Yeah, this is the Bible story, and we try to make it really fun.
Yes, ma'am.
We don't just tell the Bible story. They are the Bible story.
Awesome. So tell me, what's the story tonight?
Tonight, Jesus came in to Jerusalem, the triumphant entry.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Now, how did you demonstrate that with the kids?
Well, they all had to march. They had to learn a praise song. And then they marched on out to their next station.
There you go. So talking about the triumphal entry, you know, how do you explain the significance of that to your kids here tonight?
Well, we talked a little bit about the fact that Jesus came in on a donkey because he came in peace. He came to bring peace. Mm-hmm. And even though the celebration was wild and rowdy, what he came to bring us is peace.
Right. And, you know, this is our third night, so you've had two other stories. Quickly, what have we missed here?
What have you missed?
Yeah, what
you missed a lot of stuff. Okay, the first night Jesus was born.
Okay.
And that night we went to Nazareth, then we went to Bethlehem, then we went to the shepherds out in the field, and then we went to the far east. Mm-hmm. And so we just went everywhere that night. Second night was Zacchaeus.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
Yeah. Zacchaeus.
Okay, awesome. Now,
come on, Miss Vicky.
Yeah, Miss Vicky going to slide in here. Come on, Miss Vicky, real quick. Okay, here we go. So y'all both dressed up tonight. Are you supposed to be anybody in particular, or just we just rocking it in here tonight?
We just want to know we're in Bible times.
Right.
Bible
okay.
Times.
Yeah. I got you. And y'all are kind of a tandem here. I mean, y'all been doing it in here for a minute. tell me about that. I mean, y'all are kind of a duo in here at this point, right?
Yeah. This is our third year doing it together.
Okay.
Yeah. We play off each other.
Yeah, for sure. And you know, give us a sneak peek. You've got two more nights, three more mm-hmm. nights. Mm-hmm. What stories do we have coming up?
Tomorrow is the death and resurrection.
Oh, that's mm-hmm. a big one.
And then the next site is
Philip
and the Ethiopian.
Yeah.
Okay, got you. There you
the
go.
The evangelist.
Well, there yeah. you go. Yeah. Look, there's another group coming in, so we got to get out of the way. But Miss Vicki, thank you. Miss Elaine, thank you so much.
We have a ball.
There you
it's
go.
We
pleasure.
Have a lot more fun than the kids.
I think
do.
They do. Yeah.
Ain't nothing wrong with that. Thank y'all. All right, here we are. We are here in the Imagination Station. Tell them your names.
Noah.
Jonah Carter.
Noah, what's say yours again?
Jonah.
Noah, Jonah Carter. Okay, here we are in the Imagination Station. There's a lot going on. Noah, this is night three. How have the first nights been for you?
They've been good.
There you go. What about you, Jonah? You've had a good time out here? What you been doing the past two nights?
What they've been doing, I did get injured the
you
last
got injured?
Night. Yeah, I only been, was we was playing the game and fell. And then, I was injured somewhere.
Okay.
And then I think it just injured it more, so, yeah.
Well, I hate to hear you got hurt.
I was his teammate, and he
okay.
I walked. We were tossing balloons, and he just fell. He
okay.
fell onto a balloon, and they popped.
Okay, well, I hate to hear that you're getting hurt out here, but are we learning anything at VBS?
Yes.
What have we been learning here, boys?
So, Zach,
about Jesus.
About Jesus. What about you, John?
About Jesus.
Okay, well, come on, Noah. You got to give me something right here. What have you been learning?
We learned about that when Jesus was coming through on a donkey through town.
Yep.
We learned that the donkey signs for peace and
yep.
a horse sign symbols, a white horse symbols he's going to war.
Yep.
And Jesus came on a donkey for peace on the world.
Right, there you go, man. We're getting in depth here on the donkey. And there you go, Jonah's got the cross there. So what grade are we in here, boys?
Fourth going into fifth.
Going to fifth?
I'm in third going to fourth.
Going to fourth?
Third going to fourth.
Third going to fourth, okay.
We were in the same grade, but we weren't in the same class. We did the same class in first grade.
Gotcha. So, look, there's been there's a lot of stations y'all going through. What's been your favorite station so far?
Probably
this one in the game.
Probably
okay.
this one.
You like this one?
The same.
Probably my grandma's.
There you go. I mean,
definitely
yeah. We just talked to Miss Lane. She's got some good stuff going on. Yeah, we're having a great time out here. All right, all around right here. Give me some knuckles.
Probably the game.
And Carter says his favorite is probably the game. Ladies and gentlemen, we're at the Imagination Station. We're going to keep making our rounds here at VBS. Ladies and gentlemen, winding down VBS here tonight at Dudley Baptist Church. Look, plenty of VBSs in the summer. Get your kids involved. There's nothing better than VBS. Teaching them what Jesus did for us, paid the price on that cross, and VBS, such a great time. Anywhere you can do it. And right here at Dudley Baptist, they got it going on. It's been a fun night here, but we're signing off at VBS.
Everybody say yes, 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 yes. To VBS.